Hello and welcome to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neil Howard. Thank you so much for joining us here. In this segment, we're going to have a conversation with Mr. Mike Spiegler. He's joining us on the program to talk about Beyond Bananas, an American Kidney Fund campaign sponsored by AstraZeneca. And he's joining us as the Vice President of Patient Services and Kidney Disease Education. Thanks for joining us on the program, Mike.
Thank you for having me, Neil.
Give our listeners a brief background.
Sure. Well, for me, myself, I've got about, at this point, 20 years of experience in the public health field. Started with cancer prevention and then spent 5 years in kidney disease at the same organization I'm at now. Moved to Massachusetts with my wife, had my kids up there. Worked in anxiety disorders for about 5 years there. Came back to the D.C. area, spent a few years in food allergies, and I've been the last 5 years here as Vice President of Patient Services and Kidney Disease Education, again with my second stint at the American Kidney Fund.
I said that we were going to talk about Beyond Bananas. We've heard about the benefits of potassium. What is Beyond Bananas, this campaign that's sponsored by, supported by AstraZeneca?
Great. Well, thank you for having me again. So the thing with potassium is a lot of people do consider it as something that's really good, right? I mean, you go to work out or you wake up in the middle of the night and you have a cramp in your leg. What's everyone always tell you to do? Well, you need some potassium. You should go down and go downstairs and eat a banana, right? Okay. And that's kind of been beaten into your brain for most of your teenage and adult life. And potassium does a lot of great things. One of the things that's most important that it does is control how your muscle functions, right? So that's why when you have a cramp, people say, oh, you don't have enough potassium. Unfortunately, for people with kidney disease, you need to do a lot of great things. They filter waste from your body, extra fluid, right? That's how you make urine. They control your blood pressure. They keep your bones healthy. But they prevent you from getting anemia, which a lot of people don't know. But one of the things that it also does is controls your electrolyte balance. So, you know, things like sodium and potassium in your body. So when your kidneys start to not work as well as they had before, you start having problems controlling that potassium. And, you know, really then the kind of the seesaw shifts and you're not looking for that more potassium to try to help you. You're actually trying to limit your potassium because either too much potassium or too little potassium causes a lot of problems in your body. But again, number one, it's how your muscles work. And what's the most important muscle in your entire body? Your heart, right? So if you have too much potassium in your body, you can actually have an abnormal heart rhythm. It puts you at risk for a heart attack, other cardiovascular events. So it's very important that you keep that under control. And that's what we're trying to inform the public about if they have kidney disease.
What is a condition like this called when you have kidney disease coupled with this potassium imbalance?
Sure. Well, it's a big word. So it's called hyperkalemia, K-A-L-E-M-I-A. And that comes from, if you remember from chemistry class back in school, right? The element for potassium is a giant, you know, capital letter K, right? So that's for kalemia. That's where that comes from. So hyperkalemia, it just means too much potassium in your bloodstream.
Are there certain levels of kidney disease that causes this to be more of a problem in some patients than others?
Yeah, great question. Great question. So there are five stages of kidney disease. So one being the one that is just very slight damage, not too much to worry about, all the way up to stage five, where most people, that's what you call kidney failure or end stage renal disease. And when you get in stage five, really, you're going to need either dialysis or kidney transplant to live. So everyone's different, right? I mean, some people that end up even on dialysis still might make urine. Others, most won't. Some may have problems managing their potassium. Some maybe not quite as much. But I guess the easy way to say it is the further along you are in your kidney disease journey, usually the more likely you are to develop this condition as well as all the other conditions that come with kidney disease. So, you know, when you start to get to stage 3, stage 4, stage five, particularly those last two, that's when most people start to experience these chronic problems with too much potassium.
At the beginning of our conversation, we, of course, talked about bananas and some of the misconceptions about bananas and their function and how it relates to potassium. This Beyond Bananas campaign, is it more than an awareness campaign, more than an educational campaign? Is it really something that deals with types of medications and treatments as well?
Yeah, it does, right? So that Beyond Bananas, there's a couple different reasons why we chose that name, and that is absolutely one of them. Really, the initial impetus for it was we met some patients. We met a dietitian who said they had a patient that came in from, now I can't remember if it was Latin America or the Caribbean, but, you know, they were having trouble managing their potassium. And, you know, they said, well, I love bananas, so I had to cut bananas out. But it's no problem because I just replaced it with plantains. Well, I don't know if you've ever looked up how much potassium's in plantains, but it's actually double what's in a banana. So, you know, they thought what they were doing was a nice, safe thing for themselves, and really they were actually making the problem even worse than it was before. So we wanted to set out to say, look, you know, like I said at the beginning of the conversation, most people think, oh, I'm low on potassium, I need a banana. Well, it's more than just bananas, right? There's lots of different foods, especially in different ethnic cuisine. There's reasons why you need to think about other things that may have potassium in them. So that's one of the reasons with the campaign that we're doing. But so we're doing a lot with diet, and we have recipes and videos and kind of eat this, not that kind of information, you know, on the Beyond Bananas campaign website. But the other piece as well, to your point, is there's also other ways, in addition to diet, to control your potassium. Several different kind of medicinal treatments, and especially some new ones now that don't have some of the side effects that some of the previous ones that have been on the market for years have had.
Do you find that some of the misconceptions about potassium cause kidney disease and hyperkalemia down the line?
Not necessarily kidney disease, but it certainly can make the hyperkalemia worse. One of the things that we see and doctors see a lot is patients viewing hyperkalemia as being something that's kind of an acute thing, a sudden thing, like, okay, wow, my heart feels a little off, or I went to the doctor for my checkup, or I was at the dialysis center and got my labs, and they said my potassium's through the roof, and I got to get to the ER. We don't want people doing that kind of back and forth, you know, yo-yo effect of their potassium treatment, because, you know, what could happen is one of those times, you know, your potassium shoots up so high, you don't have time to respond to do something with it. So we want people to think about managing their potassium in a long-term chronic way, right, that they are thinking about always keeping it. You don't want to worry about that spike because, again, like that one spike might be fatal. So it's really trying to manage that, you know, overall long-term management of potassium and keeping it at a normal level.
Where can we go online and get some more information about the American Kidney Fund and this Beyond Bananas campaign?
Sure. Well, you can find us on the web at kidneyfund.org. So kidneyfund.org. And if you you can find Beyond Bananas right there on our homepage, or you can also view it as part of our brand new Kidney Kitchen site as well. So if you want to kind of jump ahead right to the diet section, you can go to kitchen.kidneyfund.org and find it there as well.
Michael, thank you for joining us here on the program this morning.
All right, I appreciate it. Thank you so much for having me.
You've been listening to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neil Howard, in conversation with Mr. Mike Spiegler, talking about the American Kidney Fund's Beyond Bananas campaign supported by AstraZeneca. Transcripts and audio of this program are available at hpr.fm and healthprofessionalradio.com.au. You can also subscribe to the podcast on iTunes, listen in, download at SoundCloud, and be sure and subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/healthprofessionalradio.